Welcome to the Leading Hope Podcast with Kevin Jack. Your influence will lead people somewhere, lead them towards hope. Everyone has 20 minutes to learn to become a better leader. Make it count.
Welcome to Leading Hope with Kevin Jack. I'm your host, VJ Williams, here with my friend and pastor, Kevin Jack. Thank you for joining us and taking time out of your day to become a better leader. We release a new episode every Wednesday, so we'd love for you to subscribe, share on social media, and bring others along with us on this journey of becoming a better leader. Visit leadinghope.online to get updates and find out more about the Leading Hope community. We are in the series of Leading Through Uncertainty, and this is episode 23, Kevin. The title today is Communicating Through Uncertainty. This should be really good.
Communicating through uncertainty.
Yeah.
So the thing that's so hard is communication is about clarity.
Clarity.
Communication is about clarity. That's why we speak. That's why we say things, to make things clear so people know what's going on and know how to respond. So the massive problem is that when you're leading through uncertainty, the one thing that you lack is clarity. The one thing that you lack is this is what's going on and this is how we're going to respond. So today's going to be a little more of an open discussion. And I'll have some pieces within here that I hope are helpful within that. But I want to talk to you about what it looks like to communicate through that uncertainty, how we can help people have clarity and what we can give them clarity on through uncertainty. But first off is a note. Don't be the person who acts like they know everything. Like, don't be the person in the midst of uncertainty who just comes in as if, like, they expected this, they knew this was going to happen, they have all the confidence in the world that everything's going to be fine, that they will lead them through. Like, there's that person who just kind of, like, walks in, and something takes everyone by surprise, and they don't know what's going to happen. They're like, we're going to be fine. Guys, we're going to be good. We have no idea what's going on, but we're going to be good.
I've been here before. I've
done it again. Exactly. Yeah.
Been there, done that.
Told you this was going to happen.
Yep.
Told you.
Always. You guys, just do what I do.
Yeah. Don't be that person. That's not what it looks like to communicate through uncertainty. Just that, like, fake bravado. I forecasted this all along. Well, let me tell you what we should all do.
Living the dream, man.
Yeah. Okay. So we're good. Don't be that person. So this is what you can be. Okay. So a couple of this is what you need to do on your own end. Some of this is what you need to lead others into. This is a little less of a self-leadership piece, honestly. This is a functional leadership and what that needs to look like, especially within the dynamics of leading teams as a whole. But I just want to give you some simple steps within this. So the first piece on this is you need to gain clarity on where you're headed / what you're seeking to accomplish and what your uncontrollable variables are. So this is simply what I'm saying. Within the midst of the uncertainty, you need to know what you're trying to do in the midst of the uncertainty, and what are the things that you can't control that might change over time. And you go, well, yeah, we know. With it, no, like I'm saying this, write it down. Like, actually write it down. Because my guess is what you're going to find is that what feels like just this overwhelming thing is actually just because there are about two or three things that you don't know. There's about two or three things that you're unsure of. And if you write that down, then you know to watch them. Then you know when you should respond. And you don't feel like everything that comes your way is just going to upend you. And it's just a wave that's going to take your feet out from under you. So it's just, I'm saying this really simply, okay? You need to know, what am I trying to do? And what are the things that I can't control? What are the things that might change over time that are going to impact what I'm attempting to do? Real simple. We talked about financial uncertainty. For us as a church, our financial uncertainty comes through giving. And so this is what we're monitoring, okay? What is the percentage of our giving compared to our previous giving? And in light of that, then what do our expenses need to be at compared to our previous expenses? If our giving is at 70% of our previous giving, our expenses better not be at 90% of our previous expenses. We're going to be in a real heap of trouble. But I actually, like, I write it down. And instead of this whole chaos and like, when are we going to meet again? When's this going to happen again? When's this going to go? Like, I know what I'm uncertain of, and I know what I'm trying to do. I know what my variables are. So that's just the first piece. Gain clarity. Just write it down. It's really, really simple. The second thing is you need to sync up messaging and method. When you're communicating through uncertainty, you need to sync up messaging and method. So here's like kind of two principles to look at within this. One of them we have talked about before. We've talked about the difference between 2D and 3D messaging. 2D is flat. It's email. It's text. It's anything that you have to guess what the tone is. 3D messaging, phone calls, video conferences, face-to-face meetings. You need to sync up what messaging will happen through flat communication and what messaging will happen through a communication that has texture, through that 3D messaging. All negative communication must happen through 3D messaging, all of it. And the tendency in a crisis, so we're in the midst of everything happening with this pandemic, and the tendency is that everything becomes an email or everything becomes a text, and you can't do that. Mm-hmm. Like, you can't do that. People still need to be communicated in ways in which we understand language. Otherwise, they're going to assume the worst throughout all of it. So sync up method and messaging. First part is through 2D and 3D messaging. And the second part of this is you need to know what communication needs to go out in different groups. Now, I'm going to talk about this from a church side, okay? And I'm hoping that for those of you in business and other portions of leadership, you'll be able to contextualize it, and I'll try to do that some. At our church, we have different kind of spheres. We have different circles of connectedness. We have our staff and leadership team. We have our hope team, which is everyone who serves in the church. We have the general congregation, and then we have the outside community. Our messaging is different at each group. The information that is shared, the kind of things that we talk about, and the 2D, 3D messaging, like how frequent that communication is different at every group. I'm not telling the outer community the same things that I'm talking to the staff about. I'm talking to the hope team about things that I'm not talking to the whole congregation about. I'm sharing insights into our strategy and what we're attempting to do that just shouldn't be there for everyone. And so you just need to be really clear. One of the errors that I see people make all the time, but especially in times of uncertainty, is they assume that everyone needs the same message. That isn't the case. You need to know which circles need which message and through what channels and in what rhythm are you speaking to the different circles. So let me talk about this just as a metaphor, and I hope this makes sense. For those of you who are married and have kids, there are things you talk to your spouse about that you don't talk to your kids about. And I'm not just saying like there are topics that you go, my kids don't need to hear about this. Not, they'll be bored. They don't, this conversation isn't for them. Operate that same way in your leadership. Know who needs to hear which conversations, be a part of which conversations, and who needs to get which messaging. And then the third step on here, so we've kind of gone through this. The first step is an internal one. It's gaining clarity on what are our variables and what are we trying to accomplish. Second thing is you're syncing up your method and your messaging through 2D and 3D conversations and knowing which circles you're speaking to. And then the third one, it kind of goes back to everything we mocked at the beginning of the, it's going to be fine, we're good, I've been here before, I knew it was going to happen. And that's your posture as a leader within that messaging itself. So here's just my notes for you, is be upfront about what you're facing. Be upfront about what you're dealing with. Like, know which circle you're speaking to and so which language you're using and how much information you're giving. But that doesn't change. Be upfront about what you're facing. Don't be fatalistic. Don't be worst case scenario. Don't be fearful. My goodness, that goes back to the oxygen mask podcast. Like, man, be encouraged in what you're saying. Have hope. Like, speak from a posture of hope. So don't be fatalistic. Don't be fearful. But be upfront. Like, be honest about what you're dealing with. People hate being surprised. They hate being surprised. Most people even hate a surprise that's a good thing. Like, we threw you a surprise party. Oh my gosh, please don't. And so, especially when it has a propensity, a possibility of being bad news, people hate being surprised. And so one of the greatest things you can do is just being upfront. And again, tailor that information, the amount of information, based upon who you're speaking to. But be upfront about what you're dealing with. Your goal as a leader is to gain clarity on what you are uncertain of so that all of it doesn't feel uncertain. And when you work through this process of, hey, I'm going to gain clarity of the variables, I'm going to know which message I need to give through which method to which group, I'm going to sync up method and messaging to the right group, and I'm going to be upfront but not fearful, you're able to communicate clarity and you're able to instill confidence even in a time that is uncertain. Our tendency is we shrink back from communication in uncertainty, and that is the worst thing you can do. Just because you don't know every possibility doesn't mean you shouldn't be giving out a message. Do it with courage, do it with confidence, and give people as much clarity as you can, even when times are uncertain.
Yeah, that's very practical. Courage, clarity, confidence, great place to be. One of the things you started, we started off obviously mocking the the people. But here's I mean,
I've got it. We're good.
And we don't, you know, we don't want to be the person who acts like we know everything. And it's an obvious statement. But I think the trap we fall in is that we've all done this at some point. And we're not proud of it. And it's not who we are. It's just something that we may have done in the past. And we've covered this in a prior podcast, I believe. And I know one of the ways you said practically combat that attitude, that behavior, is listening first and asking questions second. Is there anything else that we can do to make sure that we're not being that person? Because it's so important not to walk into the room and be that.
I think just as a whole, that person comes across as if they don't feel the room and they don't know what's going on in people's lives. And so if you're unaware of your team's struggles, if you're unaware of what all else is going on, you're always going to come across in that tone. You're always going to come across in that sense. And so being engaged, not being isolated, is maybe the most significant thing you can do to make sure you don't do that.
That's great. The second thing that you had, first of all, I hope everyone, when you do watch this or listen back to this podcast, that you do write some of this stuff down. I know I do, and I take it with me every week. You said, you asked two questions. What am I trying to accomplish? What can't I control?
Yep.
Two huge questions that if you ask yourself every day.
Oh, that's good.
Will set you up every day, no matter what you're trying to do, for success. Because you can't, the things you can't control, you can remove from your process. You can't control, it's good to know it, but you don't have to worry about it because you don't have control over it. And the other thing is, what am I trying to accomplish? That's maybe you don't know. And maybe you need to find that out.
Yeah.
Which is great. But the thing
here's a guess on just that note of what am I trying to accomplish. My guess is when you're in times of uncertainty, most people, their answer is get through it.
Yeah.
And you go, have a better answer than that?
Yeah.
Like, figure out what you're trying to cultivate. Don't just like, we get through it.
Yeah. Odds are you're going to get through it. Mm-hmm. What do you want to get through? How do you want to look like at the end of being through it?
I like that as a message of hope, which it really is. But the odds are you're going to get through it.
You are. But saying that, you know, just getting through it's probably not going to make you feel better.
Yep.
You
exactly.
Know? But the other thing is you said it, if you write them down, you'll know what to look for. Man, is that not powerful? Like, if I never took notes in my life. I never, ever did much of that. You know what I mean? I would retain information just off of the spoken word.
Yeah.
Right? And sure, some of it was retained, but most of it was vanished after a few hours. Mm-hmm. Right? If I didn't, now when I write it down, I can recall it almost all the time. And you're like, well, that's an obvious statement. Yeah, but you're not writing it down. You know what I mean? Yeah. Like, write it down. And I hope that you guys take notes when you're listening to the podcast, because, man, this just – and I know that a lot of people on the online team tell me they write down these notes, and it changes the way they present themselves in their businesses, their works, and homes. So
even if you write it down and throw the paper away, you will still have greater retention from writing.
Absolutely.
And, Beach, here's the thing that I'm just – when I hang out with leaders who are beyond me, like, they're playing the leadership game at a much higher level than I am, I'm always amazed by two things. The first thing is how quickly they're willing to execute.
Yeah.
They don't sit on decisions that they know. They just do it. Hard decisions. They just act on it. So, like, that's the one thing that just blows me away. The second thing, when I hang out with leaders who are much better than I am, is how much time they spend thinking.
Yeah.
Like, they are serious about just sitting down with pen and paper, not producing content, but thinking through the dynamics of what they're leading, the dynamics of their world, to gain a better grasp and clarity on the situation. And that time set aside for thinking is just a discipline that the vast majority of people don't have.
That's powerful. That is powerful. You also talked about 2D and 3D communication. We talk about it a lot. Something through a text.
Yep.
You know, if it's important, probably shouldn't be done through a text.
Don't communicate negative through a text.
So that's good for anybody. I mean, that's good for relationships.
Yep.
It's good for whatever you're talking.
It's good for your marriage.
It's good for your marriage. But talk more about creating the environment. I mean, we're going through this right now as we have shifted everything that we do in-house here in a physical location to online. Mm-hmm. Talk more about creating those environments that carry more meaningful discussions to that 3D communication.
Oh, that's good. I just say, like, the baseline foundation of what you're looking at is, I forget, psychologists always have the number. Most statistics are made up. So let's just throw out, like, it was like 98% of communication is nonverbal. That feels right. It may be like 107. I feel like those stats are accurate. I'm within there. The point within there just being, we understand nonverbal communication. It matters. It's important. It displays confidence. It displays empathy within there. And just the acknowledgement of, hey, be it celebration, be it struggle, be it serious, be it something that someone needs to confess or just a struggle they need to share, seeing someone else's face matters. So for our dynamic of our team, we're going, hey, this shapes what's an email. And we can't always have two-way communication. We can't always have a back and forth. But this highly informs what's an email and what we record a video of.
Yeah.
This highly informs what is a post on social media and when we're going live or when we're trying to get people in other online environments. So one of the big things we're working on right now is launching online groups and using the technology that we have to help people see other people's faces, because it matters. And you just need to know which environments those matter most and which methods and messaging within those matter most so you can execute on that.
That's great. And then the last thing I wanted to talk about, you talked about being upfront on what you're facing. I think this might be, now I've been with you for three and a half years now. I think this might be one of your best attributes as a leader.
Thanks, man.
I think because... And I think the leaders fail all day on this, all day. Mm-hmm. They'll sugarcoat how they're feeling, or they'll go the other route and just be demonstrative in how they're feeling. And I think you do it well, because when you're in a room and you come in and there's something that's not right in the culture, or something's just shifted out of alignment with what the vision is, that you come in and you're, another word for being upfront is honest.
Yeah.
And you're very honest in the room with how you're feeling about it. Now, your feeling could be right, wrong, indifferent, but you're very honest about what, how you are perceiving the situation. And what that does, it gives everyone the ability to say, this is where our leader is. Do we need to shift some stuff? Because it's very straight on. And I think if you're a leader listening now, man, be honest with the people that you're working with. We use the word transparent, whatever you want to call, but being honest in the current environment, in the place in which you're not, you might be uncertain about what's happening, but if you're honest, you're going to garner the response from your team way better than if you came in on either side of that spectrum.
That's good. That's good.
So I appreciate that about you. That's it, man. That's what we've got for communicating through uncertainty. Kevin, what do you want someone to leave with from episode 23?
Do not pare down communication in times of uncertainty because you don't know what to say. It must increase. Now, there's some set steps that you can take to make sure you're having the right messaging, but do not stop communicating because you don't fully know what's going on. Let people know what you don't know and let them know what you want to accomplish through the right means and messaging.
That's awesome. Man, thank you guys so much for joining us today for episode 23. We'll see you back next week for episode 24. Don't forget to rate, review, and subscribe. And we love hearing your stories. You can send those to us at leadinghope.online. Fill out that form. We just want to get your stories out there for other people to hear how you're working through whatever leadership things that you're working through. And at the time of this recording, we know there's a lot of things going on. So I don't know what it's going to look like when you're hearing it, but we want to be there for you. Visit behope.church. We have a lot of things going on there right now for you to be in community, to learn how to be closer to those and use these things that we talked about today. So we love you guys so much. And remember, everyone has 20 minutes to learn to become a better leader. Make it count.